The Commission on Appointments confirms the ad interim appointment of Trade and Industry Secretary Alfredo Pascual. During Pascual's confirmation hearing Wednesday morning, Congressman Johnny Pimentel said the panel has established its full confidence towards Secretary Pascual. Pascual previously said his main priorities include helping upskill and upsize small businesses, as well as promoting ease of doing business to attract new investments.
The new Philippine Social Welfare Secretary, instructed by President Marcos to increase the agency's responsiveness to natural calamities. Rex Cachalian says he was also told to make aid distribution easier through digitalization.
We've agreed na kailangan pag-aralan pa natin kung paano mas malawak yung gawing network ng logistics response ng ating departamento. May mga probinsya tayo katulad ng Pangasinan, katulad ng Quezon. Ang lalawak, mula dulo hanggang dulo, lagpas isang araw pagtatahakin. Kaya in order to make it more responsive, dapat yung mga ganung kalalaking probinsya, for response ng disaster, dapat meron tayong mga hatiin natin sa to smaller areas. Ibig sabihin, dapat may warehouse tayo, meron tayong packing centers, meron tayong mga sasakyan, may mga gamit na magdi-deliver in smaller areas para mas mabilis yung response.
Gachalian took his oath as social welfare chief on Tuesday. The former Valenzuela mayor turned district representative assured his constituents of continued service and that a caretaker will be appointed by the lower chamber.
The man whom Secretary Gachalian replaced, former DSWD Chief Erwin Tulfo, welcomes his appointment. Tulfo also says he's willing to return to the Marcos cabinet if given the chance.
I believe the president made the right choice of appointing Congressman Gachalian as the new DSWD secretary. I believe DSWD will be in good hands, and I believe that social services will always come on time, especially during calamities. I am sure he will be able to deliver because I don't want to give the president pressure the president or the administration to give me another position. No, Mike, I'm not pushing for that. If it happens, it's really there, then it's really there.
U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin visits Zamboanga City as he kicks off his second official visit to the Philippines. Our correspondent Bianca Dava now on the line with that story. Bianca?
Hi, Ron. U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin III visited the Armed Forces of the Philippines' Western Mindanao Command headquarters in Zamboanga City this morning. AFP Chief of Staff General Andres Santino and West MINCOM Commander Lieutenant General Roy Galido welcomed Austin upon his arrival. Aside from visiting U.S. troops stationed in Mindanao, Austin had a short conference with the AFP officials at Camp Basilio Navarro. Austin arrived in the country on Tuesday night, making his second official trip to the Philippines and his first under the Marcos administration. The U.S. official will meet with his Philippine counterpart, Defense Secretary Cogito Galvez Jr., tomorrow. Among the topics expected to be discussed during his meeting with Galvez and other defense officials is the Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement, or EDCA, which grants U.S. troops access to designated Philippine military facilities. The EDCA also grants the U.S. the right to construct facilities and pre-position equipment and assets, but rules out permanent basing. The U.S. Defense Secretary's visit also seeks to tackle ways to modernize the two countries' alliance to address new and emerging threats, including China's continued assertion of its claims in the West Philippine Sea. The Philippines and the U.S. share a mutual defense treaty, which stipulates that both countries will support each other in case of an external aggression. Austin's visit comes just over 2 months after U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris completed an official trip to the Philippines last November. Now, prior to his trip to Manila, Austin also visited and met with allies in South Korea. Ron?
Bianca Dava with that story. Thanks, Bianca.